Hello viewers, today we will discuss about Intel 8088 microprocessor architecture. Basic design of a microprocessor is 8088. Rest of all are improvements of 8088. So if you understand 8088 microprocessor, you can easily understand any other processor. Before discussing the architecture, we must know about some important terms used in microprocessor. Address bus, data bus. Everything a computer does by its user's input commands from keyboard, mouse and etc. These commands goes into microprocessor and microprocessor searches for a program according to our commands. The electrical hard lines between input devices to microprocessor and microprocessor to storage is called address bus. After searching the program, microprocessor fetches the program and prepares it and sends to the output devices. The electrical connections between memory to microprocessor and microprocessor to output device is called data bus. If microprocessor plays or displays whatever in its memory, like displaying a video or playing a musical file from memory, is called read. If microprocessor copies something from external devices like CD, pen drive or download files from internet to its memory, it is called write. Next one, clock. It's a clock pulse to sequence the operations in microprocessor. Fifth one, reset. Reset means restart everything from start. Switch off and on again and start from first. Sixth one, registers. These are made out of flip-flops to store information by processor like a notebook. Let's look at the block diagram of Intel 8088 microprocessor. It has two main sections, the execution unit, bus interface unit. First one, the execution unit. It takes care of processing including ALU. Second one, the bus interface unit. It controls passing of information between processor and memory, IO ports, etc. The blocks which are in green color are made up of flip-flops to transfer data. The blocks which are in orange color are designed with logic gates to perform arithmetic or logic functions. The blocks which are in yellow color are also designed with logic gates. It provides internal control to processor. The blue lines are the internal data bus to pass information between components of microprocessor. First, we will discuss about general registers in execution unit. The general registers are divided into two sets. First one, data registers. Second one, address registers. Data registers are for calculations. These are four pairs of registers: AHAL, BHBL, CHCL, DHDL. Each of these registers are 8 bits long. Each pair also operates as a single 16-bit register. AH and AL can operate as a pair of AX, BHBL can operate as a pair of BX, CHCL can operate as a 16-bit register CX. DHDL is also can operate as a 16-bit register DX. This is how 8-bit registers become 16-bit register. 8 bits of AL simply attached at the end of 8 bits of AH to make it as a 16-bit register. There is a question for you. Write its answers in comments. Accumulator. In these registers, intermediate ALU results are stored for to use in next operation. Because access to main memory makes ALU operations slower. Base register. It contains a data pointer. It stores the address of the data being calculated by ALU. Counter register. It is used to shift or rotate instructions. It is like a string manipulator. Data register. It is used to temporarily store data being transmitted to or from peripheral device. Below the data registers, there are address registers. These registers contains memory addresses from where data will be retrieved are stored. First one, stack pointer. This register stores the most recent program used by a microprocessor. If a new request comes in, they push down the older ones. Base pointer. The base pointer points the memory address of the instruction that being already executed. Source index. It points the address of the current character being read from the memory. Destination index. It points the address of the current character being written into the memory. Flags. Just imagine the dashboard of a car. There are number of indicators. Each of these lights has a unique purpose. One comes when fuel is low, another one warns low coolant level, handbrake and etc. There are number of indicators in processor also. Each one indicates as a result of previous operation can be represented with single bit. For example, the addition of two numbers might produce a negative sign, a carry, a zero, an error overflow. All these flags are grouped together to form a single number. That number is called flag register number. The control flags are used to control how the processor runs. The status flags are usually set by the previous operation. Assume that flag register set is shown after an addition of two numbers. There was no overflow as overflow flag is 0. Result is negative. Sign flag is 1. Answer isn't 0 because 0 flag is 0. There was no auxiliary carry. Auxiliary carry flag is 0. Answer is an odd number because parity flag is 0. Answer has a carry as carry flag is 1. There is a question for you. Please write its answer in comment section. ALU. The ALU performs all logical and arithmetic operations. So, ALU is the calculator of computer. If CPU becomes powerful and faster, it means ALU is designed to solve more complex operations. Then, ALU occupies more space in CPU and CPU becomes more expensive. That's why ALU is designed that much powerful enough to make CPU faster but not expensive. ALU performs all logical operations and OR and etc. Bit shifting. Shifting the position of bits either left or right, it is considered as multiplication or division. Arithmetic operations, addition and subtraction. Multiplication and division can be done by repetitive additions and subtractions respectively. Next one, EU control system. It is designed with set of gates to control the timing and passing of the data to other units within the execution system to achieve a desired result. It is just like a manager of an organization who doesn't know full details of the operations being performed, but he will plan what to do, when to do, and where to do. That's all for today. Follow me on my next video, The Architecture of Intel 8088 Microprocessor Part 2. I will explain bus interface unit. Don't forget to write answers in comment section. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe my channel and share my videos.